All right, and welcome back to the Motion VFX podcast. Again, I am one of your hosts, George Edmondson, and over to my right here we have...
Dylan John Dickerson. How you doing?
I'm doing great, man, and I'm so excited about today's podcast. So let's just jump right into the topic. 24 frames per second is the superior frame rate. We all know this, and actually, hold on, Dylan. I just wanted to confirm you are shooting in 24 because it's the better frame rate, and we'll be able to sync this video up later when we're editing in mPodcast.
I actually am not, because it is not the better frame rate. I want to see more frames per second. I want it to be nice and crisp and crystal clear. We're just going to have to make it work. Maybe I'll just be in slow motion while we sync it up or something like that.
All right, so clearly this podcast isn't going anywhere, but Dylan, you and I are going to, this is going to have to be a to be continued. We'll talk off camera about how 24 is better. But until then, why don't we just look at the mPodcast tutorial coming up next. Once again, this is George Edmondson from MotionVFX.com. Today, we are looking at the brand new mPodcast plugin. mPodcast can be located in your titles once you've installed from mInstaller. It can be located over in your transitions, and it can also be located over in your effects. So why don't we go ahead and start from the top of our short little podcast that we created here. So with our intro, we are using intro number 5, which can be located here in your intros section. So right here, intro number 5, really, really cool. I really like a lot of these. Intro number 6 is awesome. You've got this really cool little popping in microphone icon. I love it on the white. And then we also have that same icon with a little bit of a different animation in logo number 3, which is really nice. But we did decide to go with intro number 5, so let's dive in. When we click intro number 5, we can open up our inspector. And as always, with most MotionVFX.com plugins, we have our on-screen controls for position, scale, and rotation. And that is a global control. Over in our inspector, animations in and out, we can use our parameters to position, scale, rotation, and opacity there in the inspector if you'd like. Your main element type, you can change from a drop zone to background footage if you would like. Now, over in our timeline, we just have a gap clip there for the beginning, so you're not seeing that. But if we did have some footage, you can see me kind of moving around back there. That is what would be happening. So let's change that back to our drop zone. Then we can colorize, or we can keep it plain as you see here. We do have our drop zone already filled with the MotionVFX.com logo. And in order to fill a drop zone, it is really easy. You click your drop zone and then go over and fill from your content. Here, of course, we are using our MotionVFX.com logo. As we scroll down, we can make changes to our drop zone's pan and scale. So I did have to fine tune this just a little bit just to center that up. And then I really liked for this, since it is a little bit different, keeping that square, but we are using a PNG, so if I were to scale down, you can see inside that mask, we could hold that circular shape if we wanted to. But for this, we're just gonna scale that up so it's got that nice square. We can add a shadow to our element if we would like, depending on your background. We can make changes to our header here, as well as make changes to the text, font, size, etc. And then let's push on down a bit, because we see that we have the word podcast going on in the background. And of course, we can change the text for that here, along with the color, alignment, size, etc. We can toggle different things on and off if we would like, such as the description, and change our text there. And then we also have our logo, and so that is a secondary drop zone if you were to have something different, and then additional text and such here. Now, I did want to show you that you can toggle on and off the background if you'd like. So if we toggle that off, you can see that we just have me there. It's just going to show through whatever is beneath it. But then we also have this gap clip.
So remember, over in our mPodcast, we also had this variety of backgrounds. So if you like an intro, but you might want a different background or something with some texture behind it, you can turn off your background in your intro and then just turn on one of the backgrounds, and then here you go. So now, if you see, we have that animating in and together perfectly. It feels really good. We still have that same background, and then boom, they animate out together. So you would never know that those were two separate backgrounds. So really, really cool. I personally am going to just toggle that back off. Let's go back into our intro and let's toggle that background back on, just because I like it clean like that for this, and I like the animation out that it does over me. And then boom, that masks opens, and there you go. As we continue down, we can take a look at one of our lower thirds. So this is going to be lower third number 3, which is right here. But again, you have several lower thirds to choose from that all work really well and have a very clean and modern look. So let's go ahead and toggle that on over in our inspector. So as always, on-screen controls for position, scale, and rotation. Animations in and out over in our inspector. You can make changes to the position, scale, rotation, etc. with those parameters. Now we have inside content position. So notice if we wanted to move that around within our box there, we could do so. We can toggle on the shadows if we would like. We can toggle on the title and make changes to your text here, as well as your font and the additional information. We have our subtitle beneath, and then we have our waveform, which you could toggle on and off if you would like. And this is really cool. You can make changes to the color, the position, but you can even make changes to how many and how you want that waveform to look. So it's really nice, and you can fine tune that however you see fit. Make changes to your width, your height, your variant amount, your noisiness, how much animation you want going on. Really nice. So we can toggle our bar on and off. We can make changes to the opacity if we would like, the color, position, roundness. So if you wanted a rounded off look instead of the square, you can do so there. And then the size. So my name was a little bit long for the default size, so I'm just going to reset this so you can see. When I typed my name in, my name was a bit too long. And you can notice the slider is all the way maxed out there. No problem. Click and drag up. Boom. There we go. Good to go. And then we have our title background blur. So if we want it to be blurry or not, you can make changes there. As we continue to scroll down, you notice something happens. Now, we do have that same lower third there, so we don't need to go back over that. But check out that beautiful animation. Now, this is really nice, and it is working similar to how our plugin mGrid works. So this is the multi-grid, and I'm going to just turn this off. I'm going to actually delete it so I can show you how easy it is to use and apply. So we're going to delete that from there, and then let's delete it from Dylan. So we want me to pop in over to the right there, but we want to hold our audio. So the way that they have built this is actually as an effect. So if we go over and find mPodcast, we have another set of tools here. We have a circular split, so that can show you what's going on. Let me highlight me there. And notice the audio comes through really nice. We have a multi-grid, which is what we're going to be using. And then we have a split, which is just going to move both of us, but it maintains our aspect ratio. So let's drop the multi-grid on. We're just going to click and drag onto our clip. And boom, we already see something has happened. So check out this on-screen control here. This is going to be scale, and it is going to be position, but it is only going to move on that X axis for this one, because we have over in our inspector, the grid size is set to a 2:1. Now you can set that to a 2:2. So if you had 4 people, and now our on-screen control works by snapping into place wherever we want. And again, it is just so fantastic how quick and easy it is to use. And I love the fact that we are maintaining our audio, so you're not having to sync your audio in a drop zone or something like that. Let's change that back to 2:1 there. And you can see that I've snapped over to the right. Then we are going to go into our multi-grid, bring it over on Dylan. We are going to grab his on-screen control. Boom, over to the left. We are good to go. It was that simple and that easy. Now, something that I do want to change here. Let's go into our view. Let's go to our horizon on our overlays. I would like this to be centered up perfectly on me. We're going to go down into our inspector, and you can see our grid position. I want to continue to slide that grid over until it is perfectly aligned, and then I need to get my footage back centered. So as we continue down, you can see footage pan, and then I can just bring that on X back over to the left, and boom, now Dylan and I are perfectly aligned. So if the alignment isn't what you want, you can change that too. That's how customizable these plugins are. And then as we go down, if you'd like a border on, you can turn that on. You can see that white came in, and then I'm going to turn that back off. Let's go back into our view and just turn our horizon off. If you wanted to add a shadow, you can do so here. And that's about it. Really cool, really quick. Love the multi-grid, and watch how they animate together just so seamlessly. I animate in. He's kind of pushing over to the left, as you can see there. Really cool. And then it's going to animate back out collectively if we want it to. Now, continuing down the timeline, I wanted to show you our waveform number 5, which is going to be located here in our tools. Tools has a lot of great things. We've got some chapters here, which are really great. We've got this awesome countdown. We have this player, a couple different animated waveforms and things like that. But let's just say that you wanted to do your own waveform, then you would apply waveform number 5. And the reason being is because over in our inspector, we have a drop zone. And this drop zone allows you to pre-populate any sort of waveform that you want. So I'm going to go over here and open up my library sidebar, and let's just delete that. So you can see that that is a drop zone that is just animating in to fill that up. And we can click any of the drop zones. Now I have this one, but I also wanted to show you what it looks like if we were to choose a PNG. Then you can see that that PNG, that drop zone, is going to show through. It's going to have that alpha. And lastly, if you wanted to use a video, you can use a video source as well. So I'm going to apply the clip, and then check this out. This is how it's animated. So we have that animated video waveform. So a lot of really cool options there. And I thought that that was something that was really neat, a nice touch from the team over at MotionVFX that built this plugin. Then as we continue down, now with this, I really liked the hard cut look. So I'm going to toggle my animation out. I'm going to turn that off on both of these so that now it's just going to be boom. It's a hard cut right to Dylan as he was speaking, but that audio is maintained throughout. And then another hard cut back out. We animate back using our grid, and then we go into our ender here, and that is going to be located in the social media section. So you can see here that we have our ender. It just kind of picks us up and it tells you what to do. Now we also have platform icons, which are great. We have a wide variety of those social media icons. We have subscribe, as always, for things like this. So a lot is packed in here. Really nice. So we dropped in our ending from the social media section. As always, on-screen controls for position, scale, and rotation. We have our animations in and out, all of our positions. We have our content mask size. So if you wanted to make that mask bigger or smaller, you can do so there. We have our content mask roundness. So if we wanted to round that off, you can see there in the corners how that is rounding off there. we have our background footage. But if we wanted to change this to a drop zone, you can do so here, which is really nice because what if you didn't want to shrink us down? You could use your on-screen controls if you would like, but we are not going to do drop zone. We're just doing background footage because I like that one a lot. Let me reset my scale and such. Boom, there we go. Continue down if you want to toggle on your title or make changes to your text, font, colors, etc. here. And then our description, which I did do onto the tutorial because that is something that I say often. And below in our inspector, we have our icons. You can toggle those on and off if you would like, or you can make changes to each of those icons individually, which is really nice. And then as we continue to scroll down, we have our box. So we can have a gradient or a solid color if you'd like. I love the gradient. You can make all your changes to your color, etc. If we wanted a background instead, you can just toggle on your background here. So now what happens is just going to, boom, it comes in and there's already a background there, which is really cool if you like it. I kind of like black, so I'm going to leave it. And your shadow. Let's go and find our placeholders here. And all of these are really cool. These are great if you are going to be doing a quick video, some sort of a promotion. If we're going to say, hey, everyone, today this is who we're having. Be sure to go check out the podcast, something like that. I really like cover number 2 because it's got this kind of plastic wrap over it, which is really neat looking. So I'm just going to click that and drag it into my timeline. You can see how it animates in. And then in my drop zone, I'm going to populate that. So open our sidebar. So I'm just going to click that and apply clip. I'm going to use my on-screen controls to kind of scale it up so you can see what's going on here. I'm going to come down and you can see inside drop zone pan, and I'm just going to move that. But you can see that it has that really cool plastic wrap look going on over it. It makes it look like an album cover or something. If I wanted to make any changes to a kind of our plastic wrap look, you can do so here in the inspector. If you wanted to turn on a background, you can, and you're gonna get this really cool shadow here. And I'll toggle that background back off. But I thought that was a really cool looking sort of album cover. So I wanted you all to see that before we were done. And then remember, we also have transitions. So why don't I go in and let's just select some of the content from both Dylan and myself. So boom, we're going to transition between Dylan and myself there. So let's open up our transitions. And we have a bunch of different ones. They're really cool. Transition number 2 is nice. So we're just going to click that, drag it in between, and check this out. Boom. Really nice. Over in our inspector, transition number 2, you can toggle your icon on and off if you would like. Changes to opacity and position of the icon and the color, etc. Continuing down, we can toggle on the circle. So if we want just the icon, the inner side, we can do that. And you can make changes to the fill opacity, color, etc. And that about does it. Thank you so much for checking out mPodcast tutorial from MotionVFX.com. It is now available. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.